Hello everyone, welcome to Horror and Monster Collectibles, where today we are going to be taking a look at NECA's new Megadeth Peace Sells Who's Buying Vic Rattlehead figure. As soon as this figure was announced, I knew that I had to have it. I am a huge Megadeth fan and metalhead in general, and this was right up my alley. Now this figure is painted up in a cel-shaded paint deco, which I am super stoked about. It's always hard to pull off, so let's take a closer look at the figure. Okay, so we have Vic out of the box. And unfortunately, mine is missing the pile of rocks that the sign is supposed to fit into. So I contacted Big Bag Toy Store and they'll hook me up with a replacement. They always take care of me. That's why I always recommend people ordering from them. BBTS is just a fantastic company. But this guy, unfortunately, is missing the pile of rocks, which happens with mass-produced action figures. And, you know, it doesn't happen all the time, but stuff slips through the cracks. The sign is well done though, and you can see where it's supposed to fit in to the missing pile of rocks. We'll just pretend that that's there, but unfortunately pretending doesn't actually let it stand up because it falls down. All right, so let's take a closer look at Mr. Rattlehead here. And NECA has done a good job with the paint app. And I know it can look sloppy if you're not used to the styling, but it's appropriate for this cel shaded styling. And it's well done, and so is the sculpt. The body is, this is an 8-inch figure, and the body is just a basic standard action figure body. The head is on a ball joint with full rotation, but there's no like double jointed elbows or knees or anything like that here. The chain links are functional, which is cool, but again, that's just plastic, but still cool. Come down here to the body. The outfit itself, which is basic and standard. I mean, the tie is just a piece of material and stuff, but I mean, that's what you expect. There is still some good ratcheting joints here on the elbow, and even though on the shoulder I should say, and even though the elbow is just a standard joint, there's still plenty of movement here. And we'll come over to the wrist, like get the material back in the hand, which has full rotation and also like a pivot joint in there, which you can see. But it's a pretty cool sculpt, and it's made out of a soft material, either soft PVC or vinyl. There is a waist joint. Come look at the other hand. There's not a whole lot of accessories with him. Basically just the sign and the pile of rocks that it kind of sits in. Standard movement as far as hip joints, which is a decent enough to get you by. It's nothing to write home about, but there's not gonna be a whole lot of crazy poses you're gonna be doing with Vic. Although it might be fun to kind of do that, but I mean, there's not even a swivel joint here for the foot, but you do have pivot. And that's about it for him. There's not a whole lot to go over here. Take a look at the back. And that's about it. But still very cool. And also just being a metalhead, just having action figures of these characters is super cool for me. I hope that there is more in the future. I'm always down to get them. So this is how I'm going to have to display them for now until I get the missing piece, which isn't that big of a deal. I know I'll get it, and you know, stuff like this happens. But the figure itself is still really cool. I do wish it had a little bit more dynamic movement to it, I guess, but again, you're not gonna be having him in all kinds of crazy shots. So anyway, I definitely recommend the figure. I think he's cool, and I hope that they do more. I'm definitely down. Even just more Vicks would be cool, like from something else other than P-Cells, but still, great album and great figure. As always, feel free to like and subscribe, and feel free to leave any questions or comments that you may have, and I'll be happy to answer them. And until next time, I'll see you guys later.